and gentlemen, as we are all watching it on the big screen, the Honorable Vice President of India, the Honorable Governor, have arrived at the venue, and he's being given a brief introduction about the center and the academics. And after that, he will also be given an insight into the R&D activities also later on. Governor and the Honorable Chief Minister will arrive in the next few minutes, a few moments rather. So I would request all of you to kindly refrain from any movement. Please be in your seats and till the function is over, kindly be in your seats, please. And once again, a gentle reminder, please put your phones in silent. Kindly get you back to your seats very quickly. Please be seated and kindly maintain as much as possible the social distancing. And yeah, I would now request all of you to kindly rise for the national anthem, Rashtragite. Kindly sit down. Well, ladies and gentlemen, Jawaharlal Nehru Center for Advanced Scientific Research, JNCASR, is an autonomous, multidisciplinary research institute and a deemed to be university with a mandate to pursue and promote world-class research and training at the frontiers of science and engineering, covering broad areas ranging from materials to genetics. On behalf of JNCASR and the entire organizing team, I'm Shankar Prakash, extending a very, very warm welcome to all of you to the unveiling of the foundation stone of innovation and development center. Tamellarigu adarada hrutpurvaka swagata suswagata. At the outset, I would request the president of GNCASR, Professor G.U. Kulkarni, for the welcome address and also to give us a brief insight on center's activities. Professor Kulkarni.
Good noon to you all. Honorable Vice President of India, Sri M. Venkaya Naiduji. Honorable Governor of Karnataka, Sri Thavarchand Gelotji. Honorable Chief Minister, Government of Karnataka, Sri Basavaraj S. Bommai Avare. Bharat Ratna, Professor C. N. Rao. Distinguished guests, faculty and staff, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Jawaharlal Nehru Center for Advanced Scientific Research, I extend a warm welcome to you all. The occasion is laying the foundation stone for our Innovation and Development Center located at the Arkavati campus, some 22 kilometers from here. The structure is based on green building concept, occupying 36,000 square feet, and only half of it is being taken up in the first phase. This will be a facility where laboratory inventions will be taken forward for scale-up and technology transfer. The incubation spaces will be hosting startup companies with the state-of-the-art processing and prototyping tools. It is truly an honor that Honorable Vice President of India, Sri Venkaiah Naidu, is with us today. Sir, thank you very much for kind presence despite your pressing engagements. We are inspired by your keen interest towards science and technology and your continued efforts to promote mother tongue. Sir, may we request your permission to felicitate you kindly. Professor Hemlata Balram, Dean Faculty of Affairs, JNCASR, to felicitate Honorable Vice President of India. It's an honor to present you selected books authored by Professor C.N.R. Rao, Learning Science, Understanding Chemistry, and Climbing the Limitless Ladder, and founders of Modern Science in India. The last one co-authored by Dr. Indumati Rao. In addition, there is a book on Professor Rao himself, Vijnan K. Ramchandra, by Dr. Arvind Yadav. Thank you for accepting, sir. A warm welcome to Honorable Governor of Karnataka, Sri Gelotji. You have honored us with your kind presence today, and on behalf of Center, I extend our heartfelt thanks. I request you to kindly accept our greetings. Administrative Officer Mr. Joydeep Deb, May please honor the guest. Those selected books, some of them are in regional languages as well. A hearty welcome to Honorable Chief Minister Sri Basavaraj S. Bommai. Sir, kindly accept our greetings. Professor Hema, may please honor the guest. Thank you. Mananiya Mukhyamantri Gale, I recall from the records that during 1989, the government of Karnataka, under the chief ministership of Senior Bommai, Sri S.R. Bommai, granted this land for the establishment of our center, which has now grown to be a world-renowned institute in 3 decades. We are extremely glad to have your presence on this momentous occasion. Hearty welcome to Bharat Ratna Professor C.N.R. Rao. Sir, it is an honor and joy always to have you among us. Under your visionary guidance, JNCSR has reached what it is today. I humbly request Honorable Vice President of India, Sri Naidu Ji, to present a memento to Professor Rao on the occasion. As showcased in the lounge on the displays, I am proud to mention that JNCSR is a multidisciplinary research institution under Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, and as an institution deemed to be university, has reached its pinnacle globally and still rising. All this has been possible due to kind support from Government of India as well as Government of Karnataka. Here I have a request to make to the Honorable Chief Minister, if you don't mind. Sir, we seek your intervention and support in sustaining the water bodies in and around the campus. They are beautiful water bodies, but we need your support here. I request that your office may kindly intervene and take appropriate steps towards this. Thank you. Coming back to today's context, the Innovation Center, whose foundation stone is being laid, aims to become a major facilitator in taking science to society and meeting countries' mission programs. On this occasion, DST Secretary Professor Ashutosh Sharma and Chair of the Council of Management, JNCSR, Professor Govardhan Mehta, have sent their greetings. With these words, I welcome you all once again. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Professor G. Kulkarni, for extending a very cordial welcome and also giving a very quick insight into the center's activities. At this juncture, I would request the Honorable Governor of Karnataka, Sri Thavarchand Gehlot, to kindly address all of us. Devir Sajjana Swagat Kijiye, Sri Thavarchand Gehlot.
भारत के उपराष्ट्रपति आदरणीय श्री एम वेंकैया नायडू जी, कर्नाटक के माननीय मुख्यमंत्री श्री बसवराज बोम्मई जी, भारत रत्न प्रोफेसर सी एन आर राव साहब, जवाहरलाल नेहरू उन्नत वैज्ञानिक अनुसंधान केंद्र के अध्यक्ष प्रोफेसर जीयू कुलकर्णी सी देवियों और सज्जनों, आप सबको सादर प्रणाम। मुझे यहाँ यह उल्लेख करते हुए गर्व महसूस हो रहा है कि कर्नाटक एक पवित्र, प्रगतिशील और तकनीकी रूप से उन्नत भूमि है, जो महान भगवान बसवण्णा, विभिन्न संतों, सूफी संतों और एम विश्वरैया जैसे आधुनिक इंजीनियरिंग रत्नों के विचारों से प्रभावित है। आज मेरे लिए यह अत्यंत ही प्रसन्नता का क्षण है कि मैं उन प्रतिभा संपन्न युवा अनुसंधानकर्ताओं के बीच में उपस्थित हूँ जो भविष्य में महान वैज्ञानिक होंगे। बेंगलुरु शहर को हमेशा से ही एक उद्यान नगरी के रूप में स्मरण किया जाता है। हालांकि हम में से बहुत से व्यक्ति जो यहाँ पर उपस्थित हैं, विशेष रूप से वैज्ञानिक समुदाय, मुझसे सहमत होंगे कि बेंगलुरु को भारत की सिलिकॉन वैली बनने के लिए से पहले ही यह शहर साइंस कैपिटल के रूप में जाना जाता था। स्वतंत्र भारत देश में विज्ञान अध्ययन के लिए उत्कृष्ट संस्थान हो, इसे साकार करने के उद्देश्य से विश्व स्तरीय शैक्षणिक संस्थान एवं विकास संस्थानों की स्थापना की गई है, जिसमें से यह एक संस्थान है। यद्यपि कर्नाटक के धारवाड़ में एक IIT भी स्थापित है, इस संस्थान ने अपनी उपलब्धियों के कारण विश्व में एक अलग पहचान बनाई है। इस संस्थान के प्रतिभाशाली शिक्षक एवं विद्यार्थियों ने राष्ट्रीय एवं अंतर्राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर अनेक पुरस्कार प्राप्त किए हैं। इस संस्थान द्वारा स्कूली बच्चों को विज्ञान के प्रति जागरूक करने के लिए तैयार किए गए विज्ञान अधिगम कार्यक्रम कर्नाटक राज्य एवं अन्य स्थानों पर सफलतापूर्वक चलाए जा रहे हैं। यह जानकर खुशी होगी होती है कि कर्नाटक राज्य के साथ साथ देश के ग्रामीण तथा नगरीय क्षेत्र के बच्चों को विज्ञान को अपने कैरियर के रूप में अपनाने के लिए प्रेरित करने के उद्देश्य से भारत रत्न प्रोफेसर CNR राव साहब के नेतृत्व में सैकड़ों व्याख्यान दिए गए हैं। नवाचार और विकास केंद्र की प्रस्तावित स्थापना के साथ मुझे आशा ही नहीं, पूर्ण विश्वास है कि इस संस्थान की अनुसंधान और अनुसंधान संबंधी अनुवाद संबंधी गतिविधियां अधिक ऊंचाइयों तक पहुंचेगी, जिससे समाज को लाभ होगा। मैं यहां उपस्थित वैज्ञानिक एवं युवा वैज्ञानिकों को शुभकामनाएं देता हूं, उनके उज्जवल भविष्य की कामना करता हूं और मेरी वाणी को विराम देता हूं। जय हिंद, जय भारत।
The Honorable Governor of Karnataka, Shri Thavarchand Gehlot, has conveyed his best wishes to all the youth and students for a bright future. Both both dhanyavad, sir. Well, prior to the unveiling of the foundation stone, let's all sit back and watch the video in this regard. Video, please. I would now request the Honorable Vice President of India, Sri M. Venkaiah Naidu, to kindly unveil the foundation stone for innovation and development center. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a round of applause for this momentous occasion. In 1989, the Government of India, under the Department of Science and Technology, the center was started, and in a short span of 31 years, ladies and gentlemen, JNCASR has received numerous accolades and recognitions at both national and international arena, and today is another important step towards achieving much more excellence towards the unveiling of the foundation stone for Innovation and Development Center by the Honorable Vice President of India. We would also like to welcome thousands of viewers who are watching this live online, and we are thankful to them also. I would now request, on behalf of all of us, it's my privilege to request the Honorable Vice President of India, Sri M. Venkaiah Naidu, to address all of us. Bandhugale, swagatisi, gauravanvita, uparashtrapatigalada, Sri M. Venkaiah Naidu avarana.
ರಾಜ್ಯಪಾಲ ಶ್ರೀ ತವರ್ಚಂದ್ ಗೆಹ್ಲೋಟ್ ಅವರೇ, ಗೌರವಾನ್ವಿತ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿ ಆದರಣೀಯ ಶ್ರೀ ಬಸವರಾಜ ಬೊಮ್ಮಾಯಿ ಅವರೇ, ಭಾರತ ರತ್ನ ಪಡೆದವರು ಖ್ಯಾತ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನಿ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಸಿ ಎನ್ ಆರ್ ರಾವ್ ಅವರೇ, ಉನ್ನತ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣ ಮಾಹಿತಿ ತಂತ್ರಜ್ಞಾನ ಮತ್ತು ಜೈವಿಕ ತಂತ್ರಜ್ಞಾನ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನ ಮತ್ತು ತಂತ್ರಜ್ಞಾನ ಸಚಿವರು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಶ್ವತ್ಥನಾರಾಯಣ ಅವರೇ, ಜವಾಹರಲಾಲ್ ನೆಹರು ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅಡ್ವಾನ್ಸ್ ವೈಜ್ಞಾನಿಕ್ ಸಂಶೋಧನೆಯ ಅಧ್ಯಕ್ಷ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಕುಲಕರ್ಣಿ ಅವರೇ, ಶಿಕ್ಷಕರು, ಸಂಶೋಧಕರು, ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳು, ಸಹೋದರಿಯರು ಮತ್ತು ಸಹೋದರರು, ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ಜವಾಹರಲಾಲ್ ನೆಹರು ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅಡ್ವಾನ್ಸ್ ವೈಜ್ಞಾನಿಕ್ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಯ ಖ್ಯಾತ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನಿಗಳು ಮತ್ತು ಯುವ ಸಂಶೋಧಕರೊಂದಿಗೆ ಸಂವಹನ ನಡೆಸಲು ನನಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಸಂತೋಷವಾಗಿದೆ. ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನನ್ನ ಶುಭಾಶಯಗಳು. ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ಬ್ರದರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಮೀ ಇಮ್ಮೆನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೆಷರ್ ಟು ಬಿ ವಿತ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ and interact with some of the eminent scientists, young researchers of the country. I am also pleased to lay the foundation for the innovation and development center of this great institute, which will showcase its scientific breakthroughs. I am also happy today, and I feel it my privilege to be in the company of Bharata Ratna, the great son of this great country, Dr. Sri Arna Rao. I'm happy to see the vast strides and impressive achievements made by this institute in the fields of interdisciplinary science and engineering research. I was shown a detailed presentation of the good work and the great work you people are doing in this institute, in 4 campuses in this historic city. In a span of 30 years, it has established itself as a leading scientific research center with an excellent publication record. I am told that many alumni of this institute are occupying important positions in academia and industry. I am aware that the main focus of this institution, an autonomous institution and a deemed university, is to produce PhD and Master of Science students. I'm happy to learn that it was ranked 4th among the universities, 11th in overall category for 2017 in NIRF rankings. My congratulations to all of you on this occasion. I am pleased to know that the center's research has received global attention and has been recognized both in the form of granted patents and fellowships to prestigious associations in the country and overseas. I firmly believe that the research conducted by any institution should be relevant to society, be it academic or industrial. In this context, translational research assumes importance, and I am glad to note that the institution has generated over 300 patents and promoted the establishment of a few startups based on indigenous inventions. It is heartening to see Professor Rawji, who has been nominated to the prestigious International ENI Award 2020 for research into renewable energy sources and storage, continue to pursue research at this center. I believe he will receive the award from the President of Italy in a few months from now. Congratulations, sir. You continue to inspire young scientists not only in India, but all over the globe. That's why we feel proud to be in your company. I'm happy to learn that this center has built a network with other institutes of repute and established academic links with the scientists from across the globe. The intellectual atmosphere will naturally get invigorated by the exchange of ideas and interactions with scientists from all over the world. Knowing from others' experience, learning from others' experience, passing on our experience to others is the need of the hour. The setting up of the regional office of the Third World Academy of Sciences is also a feather in the cap of this center. While this institute is known for conducting cutting-edge research in a wide range of areas, I would like to suggest that the scientists and researchers here to undertake research in new emerging areas of science like synthetic biology, computational biology, high-performance engineering material, and artificial intelligence. It is also equally important and useful to the country if you are able to focus your attention on agriculture research, because agriculture research, agriculture is the basic culture of our country. We need to support agriculture by new innovations, by providing new solutions to the challenging problems they are facing. If you talk about global scenario, I find this institute has made excellent impact on the international arena by positioning itself among the top institutions in its area of expertise. I hope it will continue to maintain its standing and continue on its quest for excellence, making it one of the best universities in the world. Quest for excellence, that should be our objective. Every scientist should strive to excel and innovate for improving the lives of the people. The purpose of science and research is to make the people's life more comfortable, make the people more happy. Mere acquisition of wealth is not going to suffice. You must really provide them a happy, healthy life. In other words, scientists should come up with out-of-box solutions to address various challenges faced by the mankind, from climate change to agriculture to health and medicine, among others. This premier institute, which is in league with prestigious organizations like IISc, IITs, and IESERs, can contribute immensely towards fostering scientific temper in the country and improving research outcomes. The National Education Policy 2020 will ensure that the students have access to new teaching and learning strategies across all segments. This will create the right educational ecosystem, enrich their knowledge base, as also honoring their skill sets. A number of new IITs, IIMs, central universities, and skill development centers have come up across the length and breadth of the country in the last few years to achieve this objective. I understand that the Government of India proposes to set up a National Science and Technology Research University bringing DSTs and R&D institutes under its umbrella. I'm happy to note that this institute is playing an active role in this regard. My dear students, youngsters, you are the future of the country. I must say, you are quite fortunate to study here and carry out research on modern-day cutting-edge science and technology under the guidance of eminent scientists. Also, this sort of serene environment provides the right ambience for students to pursue research in their chosen fields. I appreciate and endorse the suggestion of the director that the state government, I'm sure it will, should protect the water bodies across this research and innovation center. They are very much required. Bangalore is blessed with so many lakes and water bodies. Slowly, they are getting degenerated. It's because of people's carelessness and also encroachments at various levels and timely inaction. So keeping this in mind, I hope the new chief minister, who is dynamic, who is knowledge people friendly, will focus his attention on the maintenance and regeneration of the water bodies in and around Bengaluru, in the state of Karnataka, and also around this institute. Science is the backbone for the progress and technological advancement of any country. India is uniquely blessed with a huge demographic dividend, with a young population. 65% of our population is below 25 years. It's a great opportunity for India to grow. Along with that, our youngsters, they are blessed with inherent knowledge. Inherent knowledge. What is required is upgradation of their skills, their knowledge, encouragement, and blessing from people like Professor Sriyana Rao and the faculty members in various institutions. The need of the hour is to inculcate scientific temper from a young age and promote world-class scientific research that addresses societal problems. My dear students, you have embarked on an exciting career, and you must leave no stone unturned to achieve your goals. Please remember that there is no substitute to hard work. Hard work and discipline. You must always try to push the boundaries and never remain content or complacent with the status quo. You are among the privileged students who are receiving quality education. You should make optimum use of the opportunity you have got and shine like bright stars. With the knowledge and exposure received from this center, I am sure that you will contribute to national growth in a significant way. I would also urge the faculty members to ensure a congenial atmosphere for students to study, explore, and conduct research. I am pleased to learn that this center has been organizing science outreach programs. Students from nearby, they are coming here, visiting this facility and trying to interact with the faculty so as to enrich their knowledge. I'm happy you are doing it for the past 2 decades, and in the coming days also I hope that you will further focus on outreach program, and that will benefit thousands of students and teachers of education institutions not only in Karnataka but also to Uttarakhand. I'm happy to know that these programs were conducted online mode during the pandemic, because there is no substitute, that we have to take advantage of it, convert this disadvantage into an advantage, and then try to reach out and convey to the younger generation. I am also happy to know when the director has mentioned that 40% of the students are all women. That's a very positive trend. It should be encouraged further. I would like to see in all education institutions, all, that more than 50% of the students are women. I can share with you, when I go around the country, visit various universities, I'm going to IITs, IIITs, IIMs, various research institutes, particularly agriculture research, right from Jammu Kashmir to Andaman. to enrich my knowledge, to encourage the students and scientists. I find, and I have to give the degrees, because vice president cannot give degree to 1,000 people or 1,500, they make it that such a way that only top bright gold medalists are given awards by the vice president. So to my happiness, I found in every institute nowadays, more than 65% of the medal winners are girls. I am very happy about it. I would like to compliment the institute for the work done in connection with the COVID-19 pandemic situation and the steps initiated to promote few startups in indigenous activities in line with Make in India program. I am also happy to note that Innovation and Development Center to promote incubations and translational research would host startup companies initiated with the in-house inventions. I would like to once again compliment Professor Sirna Rao for igniting young minds across the length and breadth of the country through his research and inspirational scientific lectures. Even at this age, he is reaching out to the students and coming here to the institute regularly and also conveying his thoughts and his experience to the scientific community through his lectures. My best wishes to all the faculty members and students. Namaskara, Dhanyavad. Jai Hind.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Vice President of India, Sri M. Venkaiah Naidu, has called upon the entire fraternity to always strive for excellence and come out with out-of-box solutions which are people-friendly and society-friendly. Let's all once again give a huge round of applause for the Honorable Vice President for taking time off and coming here and inspiring and motivating all of us. Thank you, sir. Dhanyavadikul. I would now request Professor Hemalata Balram, Dean Faculty Affairs, JNCASR, to propose a vote of thanks. Words of thanks, yeah.
It's my honor to express the final words of thanks. I, on behalf of JNCASR, take this opportunity to thank Sri Venkaiah Naidu, Honorable Vice President of India, and the chief guest of this event to have graced this occasion and unveiled the foundation stone of the Innovation and Development Center and addressed the gathering. Sir, we shall follow your words of wisdom and contribute to the scientific and technological growth of our country. I also thank Sri Thavarchand Gehlot, Honorable Governor of Karnataka, and Sri Basavaraj Bommai, Honorable Chief Minister of Karnataka, for having graced the occasion. I would like to take this opportunity to place on record our appreciation to the Government of Karnataka for their continued support. My special thanks to our mentor, Professor Bharat Ratna, Professor C.N.R. Rao, for sparing his time and providing us with valuable suggestions. I would like to thank our President, Professor G.U. Kulkarni, for his leadership and guidance in the organization of this event. I also thank Mindspace Architects and Benaka Developers for their active involvement in conceptualizing the Innovation and Development Center. I'm thankful to the press and special invitees for their participation. A big thank you to the deans, faculty, students, and staff of the center for all their help in getting this event together. Last but not the least, I would like to extend a special thanks to this August gathering here and online who have made this unveiling ceremony a grand success. Thank you all once again.
I would request all of you to kindly stand, rise for the national anthem. Kindly be in your seats, please.
Ah, sir.